Alright guys, so this video is going to focus on how to find the perimeter of the following shape that I have right here. So when it comes to finding perimeter areas or really volumes of shapes that we're not so familiar with, or maybe shapes that don't have a designated formula for. We have, you know, formulas for perimeter of rectangles, squares, all sorts of different shapes. But when we have interesting shapes that we don't have specific problems for, we might have to do a little bit of backtracking or a little bit of tweaking to some of the information that we already know about it. When it comes to finding the perimeter of a shape, so hopefully we do know that perimeter is the distance around. So I always like to think about a security officer. If you're a security officer, you always hear them talk about, you know, walking the perimeter. So walking the outside of the building. So if I was a person, if I was a security officer and I was standing here and I was walking the perimeter, you know, how far would I have to walk? Where all am I walking? And I would have to make my way completely around this shape here. Right, so one of the most important things when finding the perimeter is that we do know all the values of the lengths of the sides of our figure here. So for example, if I start walking this direction over here, so I do have this notation that this is 14 feet. When I go down here, that's 20 feet. I don't have anything marked for these other sides here. So we need to kind of just do a little bit of process of elimination and try and figure out what those lengths are. Now I do want you to think about a typical rectangle. So if we're looking at a rectangle, what we hopefully do know about a rectangle is that opposite sides are equal. So whatever distance this is the same thing. And whatever distance this one is over here, so is that one. All right, so I know with rectangles, opposite sides are equal. I'm going to use that in order to solve this particular problem that I have here. I know that this length right here is 14 feet. So that would then comprehend, or I could then say, hey, if this entire length here is 14 feet, this length here would have to add up to 14 feet. Because technically this is the entire length across. It's just kind of broken up into this section right here, and then this section right here. Now, I don't know how long each one is individually. I have no idea how long this is. I have no idea how long this one is. But I do know in total, both of these lengths are 14 feet by what I know about rectangles. And I can say the same thing for this side over here. If this entire side here is 20 feet, this entire side over here is also 20 feet. And that's just going to be broken down with this side here and this one here. These two together will be 20 feet. So technically, when I'm finding the perimeter of this, so let's see, I have the 14 feet that I know, plus the 20 feet that I also know here. But this side opposite over here is also another 14 feet. And this length over here is also another 20 feet. I don't know why I keep putting commas. I'm supposed to be adding these together. We do know finding perimeter, you add up the distance all the way around. So 14 feet plus 20 feet plus 14 feet plus 20 feet. That is going to give me the total perimeter of this. So if I add all of these up together, let's see, that is going to give us 68 feet total.